You don't know why people are going crazy, why they are writing nonsense.
Good morning, Shepherd.
Hello, can you hear me now?
Good morning, sir.
We will be talking about S-block elements, especially okay. Yes. In S block elements, what is cement, sir?
No.
In good olden days, people were using mortar to construct the buildings. People were using mortar. Mortar is an intimate mixture of slaked lime. Mortar is an intimate mixture of slaked lime and sand with water. So there used to be a setup on the ground. They used to make a small pit-like thing in the sun. You are bringing a scenario where I will disable you to write. Is it really required?
Yes,
sir. You have disabled because they are scribbling unnecessary things.
Yes, sir.
On a circular, on a ground, you make a circular pit with some depth like this. And now, here you put a mixture of the slaked lime, calcium hydroxide, and sand, and water. And here there will be a heavy roller-like thing. Here they put a buffalo or a ox. The ox or buffalo will be moving in a circular way so that it moves. With the help of this moving heavy disc, a calcium hydroxide sand water mixture is ground nicely so that it gives a pleasant smell. That mixture is called mortar. Mortar is an intimate mixture of slaked lime, sand and water. It was a construction material which was used to construct your Char Minar, your Jumma Masjid, Makkah Masjid, your assembly building, parliament building, all those old with mortar. Mortar buildings are strong, will be hot in the building. But the problem is it is expensive and it takes time to make it. Whereas cement is very cheap and it can be made very quickly. Due to the reason that cheapness and also ease of manufacture, people are using cement today. Cement can have strength, sometimes even better than mortar. Now, what is I don't know when I'm talking. Complete S block is the syllabus for exam. Also, which you should work out, I am sending right away. You can see yourself. You can see yourself. Okay. This is the S block elements prescribed by NCERT, showing all types of questions. Type 1 questions have only one correct option. Type 2 questions have more than one correct option. And type 3, type 2 questions have more than one option. And type 3 questions, these are matrix short answer type questions. Type 4 questions are matrix match. Type 5 is assertion reason. And of course, type 6 is long answer questions. I am sending this booklet to all of you. I want you to complete this booklet by tomorrow 10 p.m. If you can do it, if you read the NCERT book 7 to 8 times, your preparation is 100%. You need not have to read anything other than this. You have to have this NCERT book I have sent across, or you can buy the intermediate textbook. Intermediate textbook is nothing but the same. You can use that and read. You got these scopes, sir, what you have to read? Any doubt, any clarity, clarification you require now? Hello?
No, sir, clear.
This syllabus is only S block elements. Now I will be showing you some 20 ideas. You can count 20 ideas. You start counting.
Good morning, sir.
Now I'll start. Now, actually, people keep on joining, means time is kept on wasted on this. Now I will not admit anybody till some
start
time.
The meeting, sir.
Okay. Excuse me, sir. Yeah, it meant I lock the meeting. Then they start crying. Sir, I got dislodged. You please join me. Like that, they call me. Sir, these are the questions you have to try. First, I will do 4 questions. The alkali metals are low melting. Which of the following alkali metal is expected to melt if the room temperature rises to 30 degrees? As you are going down the group, melting points drop. Cesium is a liquid at 30 degrees. Down any group, melting points decrease, whether it is alkali metal or alkaline earth metal. Also, alkali metals have only one electron per atom involved in metallic bonding, whereas alkaline earth metals have 2 electrons per atom involved in metallic bonding. Therefore, alkali earth metals have higher melting point than alkali metals. That is our question number 1. Are we very clear about it? Yes, and now we are looking at question number 2. I will do only 4 questions in this. Alkali metals react with water vigorously to form hydroxides and dihydrogen. Which of the following alkali metals react with water least vigorously?
Lithium.
The reactivity with water increases down a group. So cesium reacts more violently. Lithium reacts very less. In second group, beryllium and magnesium would not react with cold water. Next. The reducing power of metals depend on various factors. Reducing power means ability of a metal to lose electrons. Suggest the factor which makes lithium the strongest reducing agent in aqueous solution.
Hydration enthalpy.
It is its highest hydration enthalpy of lithium ion that makes it the best reducing agent. The sum of sublimation energy, ionization energy, and hydration enthalpy put together is called electrode potential. The largest negative electrode potential of lithium makes the best reducing agent, universal reducing agent, or universal anode. The nickname of lithium, universal anode. Metal carbonates decompose on heating to give metal oxide and carbon dioxide is true.
The answer of third one. Second.
What is your doubt? What is your doubt, sir?
Answer of third one.
Answer Excuse me?
One. Answer of third one, sir.
I already said it is in the given options, hydration enthalpy. I am trying to explain more than that is given. If you don't want, I simply say answer and keep quiet. If you want me to say answer only, I will say answer and keep quiet. There is no problem. Should I do that, sir?
No, sir.
Only answer you want?
No, sir.
No. See, again, every time whenever they join, no, I'm not admitting till 10 minutes. the metal carbonates decompose on heating to give metal oxide and carbon dioxide is true for second group metal carbonates. In first group, only lithium carbonate decomposes due to diagonal relationship. The ability to decompose are the thermal stability of carbonates, of hydroxides, of sulfates increase down the group. Therefore, as you are going down, the carbonate and the sulfate become more and more and more stable. And the question is, which of the metal carbonate is most stable thermally?
Barium carbonate.
Perfect. So these are the model questions I have shown you.
Barium carbonate.
Now you have to do all the questions. Single answer correct, multiple correct. Please try to answer all these questions before 10 p.m. tomorrow, Saturday.
Okay, sir.
Please invest time on this. Now we are looking at NCERT book, sir.
Okay.
We are going from bottom to front. I am going to tell you 20 points. You count point number one. What is cement? Cement is a mixture of various oxides of calcium, CaO 60%, sand SiO2 25% max, aluminium oxide maximum 10%, magnesium oxide maximum 3%, ferric oxide 2%, and sulfur trioxide 2%. The most important point is the ratio between SiO2 and aluminium oxide in a good quality cement is anything between 2.5 to 4%. Another parameter, the ratio between calcium oxide to all other oxides present in cement must be as close as possible to 2. What are the raw materials to make cement means the limestone CaCO3, the clay. What is actually clay means clay is actually sodium aluminosilicate. What actually is being done to make cement? You take the clay and the limestone. You grind them, you add water, you heat very strongly. Then you make small ball-like things. And again, you grind them and you add gypsum CS442H2O, about 3%. Why are you adding gypsum? If I don't add gypsum, the cement will set too rapidly. To slow down the process of setting, I am adding gypsum. What is gypsum CS442H2O? Actually, chemically, what is cement? Chemically, cement is a dicalcium silicate Ca2SiO4 by 26%, tricalcium silicate Ca3SiO5 by about 51%, and calcium aluminate by about 26%. How and why cement sets? Cement on adding water becomes hard mass due to probable hydration. What are the exact chemical reactions involved? We do not know yet. What is the use of cement? The cement is used mainly as a construction material to make dams and buildings and also make reinforced cement concrete, RCC. What is RCC? Reinforced cement concrete. What does it mean? The cement is made to get solidified over an iron jolly or frame. Then that is called RCC. That gives extraordinary strength. Okay. We talked about cement. Next. What is a gypsum? Gypsum is CaSO42H2O. Is it occurring naturally? Yes, it occurs naturally. What do you call naturally occurring gypsum? We call naturally occurring gypsum as alabaster. A-L-A-B-A-S-T-E-R. Alabaster is a naturally occurring calcium sulfate. The CaSO42H2O gypsum is actually used to give life to soil eroded by seawater. The gypsum CaSO42H2O is added to cement to increase the time of setting. Main use of gypsum on heating gypsum CaSO42H2O, it loses 1.5 mole of water to give CaSO4 1/2 H2O. The CaSO4 1/2 H2O can also be written as 2CaSO4.H2O. Chemically, it is called calcium sulfate hemihydrate. This CaSO4 of H2O is used to make chalk piece, which you used to write on the board. Chalk piece is CaSO4 of H2O. Chalk is different. Chalk is a naturally occurring ore. Its formula is CaCO3. Sir, CaCO3 is chalk. Chalk piece, a white crayon which is used to write on board, is gypsum, CaSO4 of H2O. The CaSO4 of H2O is also called plaster of Paris. The plaster of Paris is used to make idols, chalk pieces, and whenever there is a fractured bone, to make that part immobile, we are using plaster of Paris bandage. Plaster of Paris is widely used to make bandages and idols and also chalk pieces. What is plaster of Paris? CaSO4 half H2 or 2CaSO4 1H2. How it is made? By heating gypsum at 120 degrees centigrade. Sir, what happens if I heat it to 200 degrees centigrade? If you are heating at 200 degrees centigrade, gypsum will completely lose water to become water. CaSO4. The CaSO4 is not able to set on adding water. So it becomes useless, called dead burnt plaster. Next. Sir, what is slaked lime? It is calcium hydroxide. How it can be made? By adding quicklime CaO2 to water. What do you call calcium hydroxide otherwise? We call calcium hydroxide otherwise as milk of lime. Generally, milk is that which is hydroxide. Milk of magnesium means magnesium hydroxide. Milk of lime means calcium hydroxide. What is the use of milk of lime or slaked lime? The main use of milk of lime is as a paste to apply on walls. If you apply milk of lime on walls, it looks very white and it kills all the bacteria and fungus. Once upon a time, for whitewashing, we were using milk of lime. Nowadays, we are using paints. What is the main important role of milk of lime? A mixture of calcium hydroxide and NaOH is called soda lime. What is soda lime? Mixture of calcium hydroxide and NaOH. What is the use of soda lime? NaOH and calcium hydroxide, soda lime, is used in organic chemistry. Mainly, it can absorb carbon dioxide. Wherever you want to remove carbon dioxide, happily you can use soda lime. What is soda lime? Mixture of calcium hydroxide and NaOH. Well, milk of lime has another important use. The slaked lime or milk of lime is used to react with chlorine. In earlier good olden days, I used to talk 3-4 hours on this subject. The bleaching powder is manufactured by reaction of slaked lime and chlorine. The Beckman tower is used, principle of counter currents. Oh, so much I used to talk on bleaching powder. Luckily, from your syllabus, they have removed all that. It is not there. And nowadays, the rule is they are asking questions only which are there in the textbook. Even one bit they are not asking, which is not there. Therefore, there is no point in catching a ball crossing the boundary. Sir, when you are playing cricket, if you cross the boundary and catch the ball, what happens, sir? Hello?
Not out.
You can break your legs, but it is of no use. And it will be sixer only, mind you. Yes? So doing anything which is not there in the NCRT is like catching a ball crossing the boundary. If you want, you can use other books. I have no problem. My problem is, what is bleaching powder? Bleaching powder is a product obtained when silicate lime reacts with chlorine. What is the formula of bleaching powder? Unfortunately, they gave bleaching powder as a mixture of CaCl2 and calcium hypochlorite, CaOCl, taken twice. Unfortunately, it is not correct. Then you will ask me, sir, what is correct? I am telling you, sir, please learn from NCRT. Also try to learn what is fact. Bleaching powder, we are seeing bleaching powder. Bleaching powder is actually an exchange compound like calcium chlorohypochlorite. One Cl has minus charge, one OCl also has minus charge. Calcium has plus 2 charge. It is called calcium chlorohypochlorite. This particular Cl has minus 1 charge. Oxygen oxidation number is always minus 2. Because overall OCl has minus 1 charge, the Cl must have plus 1 charge. In bleaching powder, calcium chlorohypochlorite, one Cl has minus charge, one Cl has plus 1 charge. These two Cls are different. It is called as a mixed salt of hydrochloric acid and hypochlorous acid. Bleaching powder is mainly used to bleach brown color in paper industry. In paper industry, if you want to get white paper, you have to bleach the color. For that, use bleaching powder. Also, in swimming pools, we often use bleaching powder to kill the germs. Bleaching powder is also sprinkled in toilets to clean them. It eats away the skin. Don't keep it in touch with your human body. Okay, sir. Only this much I want to talk on bleaching powder. Are we very clear? Yes, sir. So, what is the use of slaked lime? It is used in the preparation of mortar. Slaked lime is also used as a whitewash disinfectant in nature. It is used to make soda lime. Soda lime is a mixture of NaOH and CaOH twice. Also, the second lime is used in glass manufacturing, in the tanning industry, for preparation of bleaching powder and purification of sugar. For purification of sugar, you require CaO. This is obtained by heating bones of animals. About that, yesterday we spoke. Okay, sir? Next question is, what is a limestone? Limestone is CaCO3. Is it available in nature? Yes, it is available in nature. In what forms it is available in nature? CaCO3 is available in nature as marble. Whatever the marble stone you talk is really CaCO3.
Sir.
Yes, sir. Marble stone is nothing but CaCO3. So if you sprinkle the lemon juice on marble, it will lose its shine, it gets patches. Because marble is CaCO3, that is basic in nature, you are adding lemon juice, which is acidic in nature, so it will eat away. You see, marble flooring, you require skill to maintain it. Marble is CaCO3, I said again. Okay, sir, are we very clean on this idea? There are other names for marble. Other variants of CaCO3 can be chalk, are simple limestone. Sir, chalk and simple limestone are not shining like marble. Why? Because they have different packing arrangement. CaCO3 packing difference. There is a difference in packing. There is a difference in look. What is CaO? CaO is called quicklime. How it is made? By heating limestone. How CaO looks like? CaO looks like a white amorphous powder with very high melting point. What happens when CaO is added with water? It reacts violently to give calcium hydroxide. What happens if I put CaO in air? It absorbs moisture to give calcium hydroxide. It absorbs CO2 to give CaCO3. What is the nature of CaO? It is a metal oxide, basic in nature. So what happens? Because it is a base, you are hero, so you go behind heroines. Don't you go behind heroines? You happen to see a beautiful girl on the road. You try to look at her, or you try to follow her, or you try to talk to her naturally. Because you happen to be a hero, you are after heroines. Because calcium oxide happened to be a base, it goes after acidic oxides. For example, calcium oxide can react with sand SiO2, because sand is acidic oxide, to give calcium silicate. Because CaO is basic in nature, it reacts with phosphorus oxides, because phosphorus oxide is acidic, to give calcium phosphate. What is the use of CaO? It is a cheap base used in the manufacture of cement. It is used in the manufacture of Na2CO3. It is mainly used in the purification of sugar syrup in sugar industry. Are we clear about this, sir? Hello? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Hello?
Yes, sir.
No, sir.
Yes, sir.
Beryllium behaves differently from the rest of the second
group. Yes, sir.
Okay. Beryllium behaves differently from the rest of the second group metals, like lithium behaves differently from the rest of the first group metals. Always the first element behaves differently because of its small atomic size, high electronegativity, and absence of d orbitals. In what way beryllium is different from 2A group metals? Its oxide is amphoteric, its chloride is covalent, and its carbonate is very, very unstable. Beryllium, like aluminium, cannot be attacked by concentrated nitric acid, as it makes a thin oxide layer around it. Sir, what is the specialty about beryllium chloride? Its preparation itself is difficult. Beryllium magnesium chlorides cannot be prepared by dehydrating their aqueous solutions. If you want to make calcium chloride, you can evaporate the solution and get CaCl2. But if you want to make MgCl2, you can't evaporate the solution to get MgCl2. If you want beryllium chloride, you can't evaporate the solution of beryllium chloride to get beryllium chloride solid. No. Reason, the beryllium chloride, magnesium chloride react with water to give their hydroxides. This reaction with water is called hydrolysis. Then how to make beryllium chloride is a wonderful question. Beryllium chloride can be made by heating BeO, beryllium oxide, with carbon and chlorine. Magnesium chloride can be made by heating MgO with carbon and chlorine. Beryllium chloride is an interesting polymeric substance. Let us look at the structure once for beryllium chloride. The time is up. I have shown you the model questions. I will share the material also. In which group I should put the material, sir? Hello? Hello? Hello?
Can you download the example?
Can you download this material yourself, or should I share it?
Share.
How can I share? To whom? What WhatsApp, is your group name?
WhatsApp group is there, na, sir.
WhatsApp group.
Kazim sir will be forgetting. So you put me hi once. Any one of the group I'll send across. Okay. You have to do that material fully. You will learn beryllium chloride structure before we break. Sir, beryllium chloride, the two Cs are lying in the plane of your tab. These two, one is going behind, one is coming in front. So the structure of beryllium chloride is not in one plane. It is non-planar, non-linear, zigzag structure. This is the solid structure of beryllium chloride. In vapor phase, beryllium chloride at very high temperature exists like BaCl2 linear. At a low temperature in vapor, beryllium chloride exists like dimer. One Cl is going behind, one Cl is coming in front, two Cl's are straight. So the beryllium chloride has structural variation. It is a covalent compound. All other chlorides of 2A group metals are ionic compounds. And beryllium chloride has a great love to water. It can take 8 water molecules. As you are going down the group, the chlorides and nitrates lose love to water. The number of water molecules bound to molecule will decrease. Okay. So about this group, you have given me data. I will. There is a group named MSJC IIT WhatsApp group. In that I will post. Okay, sir. So I have tried to give you an outline of the lesson. I think I covered 0.01%. 99% you will cover by reading yourself and asking me doubts, if any. I gave an idea what are the elements in 1A group: lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium, francium. They all give flame test. In second group, beryllium, magnesium do not give flame test. Only calcium, strontium, barium give flame test. These oxides are added in Diwali crackers to give beautiful colors. And beryllium, magnesium do not give flame test because their atoms are small, electrons are tightly held. Only when electrons are loose and get excited, de-excited, you get color in flame. And we have seen the compounds made by them, their biological importance, and some standard questions. We have concluded the S block. Monday, we will be starting the P block. 13th group, we do for 5 days. 14th group, we do for another 5 days. So,
okay.
By 16th of next month, we complete inorganic part. On 18th, I am starting organic. October 18th is the day to start organic. I will be dealing organic chemistry till December 15th. On December 15th, your organic, inorganic will be completed. Then December end onwards, we start the revision. That is the plan. Are we very clear in what we are doing, sir?
Yes.
Hello?
Yes, sir.
I am also sending across the data which you desire. You do the material full without any doubt. Okay. You said the name of the group.
Yes, sir.
What is the name of the group you said? JLIIT. Okay. Be online, be available. Please be available.
Yes, sir.
James Pratt. IIT. What is the group? JLIIT. JL. Yes. I have sent right now. Please check up whether you receive.
Yes, sir. Received, sir. Received, sir.
Please do it 100%. Okay.
Yes, sir. Received.
All varieties of questions to do in that. Okay. Ask me doubts, if any. And tell me if there are any key mistakes. In government books, there are key mistakes, unfortunately. So if you have a doubt or if you feel there is a key mistake, let me know. We will be meeting on Monday again with 13th group. Bye-bye.
Excuse me, sir.
Have a wonderful time, sir. Try to do your best in the exam. Okay. Also, yes, I want to tell you one thing important. Do we have 1 minute time? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. A student of mine is there. Her name is Turga Revati. She has done her intermediate in 1991. She has done her BTech from Government Institute, IIT, and then she has worked in US. Then she gave up the job. She is doing leadership training programs, conducting leadership training programs. And one talk she has sent me yesterday.
Oh.
How to talk? If you know, you hear that YouTube video, you will be appreciated by the world. She says how to talk. that video I felt very interesting. Just I want to share that.
I am sharing the same group.
That link I want to share. Just I will show you. I don't know. I will just show you if there is 1 minute time.
Okay.
I don't know whether there is time. I'm more worried.
There's a
2 minutes, 25 seconds, sir.
Yeah.
We can rejoin, sir.
Randomly, I am showing leadership unlocked. She will be having many videos. Be silent to listen is something interesting. This is very, very important. Think before you speak. How can I share that?
Do you really need to say? Now comes the hitch. Hitch is nothing but, is it
please helpful? Link and download
what
yourself.
I want to say right now, is it going to help the conversation? Is it going to help the other person? Is it going to help the situation? Mm-hmm. Or is it going to deteriorate the situation even more? And if it is not really helpful, you might want to pause and you might want to think, is that really something that I want to say or need to say right now? And now comes the filter, that is the I. A lot of people think that I actually means important. Is it important? Here's the problem with that question. For everybody, what they want to say at that point of time is always important. So it's very rare that the answer to that would be a no. Hence, we will not ask ourselves, is it important? But we're going to ask ourselves, is it inspiring? Yes, the way I'm going to say this, the words I'm going to use, that going to motivate and elevate the other person, or is that going to demotivate and demoralize the other person? Am I saying it in a way that inspires them to take positive action, or am I saying it in a way that demotivates them into reacting negatively? So ask yourself this question and see if you want to change the way you're phrasing whatever it is that you want to say. So I stands for inspiring. So T stands for is it true? H stands for is it helpful? I stands for is it inspiring? Then comes N, which according to me is one of the most powerful questions you can ever ask yourself, especially in heated conflict conversations with people who are very important to us. Is it necessary? Is it necessary? Is it needed for me to say this right now? What if I don't say it? What's going to happen? What's the impact it's going to create? What's it going to do? Is this something that is necessary? Is it relevant to this particular context, to this conversation? Or am I bringing something from age-old time?